We're about to go see what Boostane feels like for the first time. Mexico to check out the Boostane, and my buddy flagged me down. He got his new Roush, flagged me down. So we're gonna check that out real quick. Here it is, 2006 Roush Stage 3. Just picked it up. So it's crazy who you find on your way to Mexico. So he's on the phone, but we're gonna talk to him here in a second. I was literally.
Don't you have a work?
I just got home. I was literally.
I didn't think you were home that early.
So no. I switched over the tune to a Boostane tune.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't tried it yet.
Right.
So I was about to just go find some back roads in Mexico,
right,
and go. I haven't tried it yet, so
right.
I wanted to see what it felt like. So.
How far back? I'll follow you.
I was gonna go down here.
Mm-hmm. I'll just
follow. I don't know how.
I mean.
Yeah.
I was taking. That's my son.
I was
taking for a ride. And I was like, oh, I'll take a ride. Just that because
with
the fucking battery in it.
Yeah.
Put my new plates on and stuff.
All right.
So. Because the battery's fucked. It wasn't even the. It's not even the battery. It's got that fucking Ford draining issue.
Yeah.
So I'm hoping it fucking. Because the new gel battery, this new deep cycle, take care of that issue. You know, because the guy used to keep it on tinder.
Yeah.
And I'm like, you can't keep it fucking on tinder forever, man.
Yeah.
You know, and I don't even like that idea. So. So
it's gorgeous. It's gorgeous.
They fucked it up.
Yeah.
They put this on. They fucked this bummer. I mean, it's fucked up underneath, so I can't take that plate off. You know what I mean? And
is it cracked?
No, but it fucking like fucking put fucking screws in it and shit, and I mean the bumper is fucking pretty much junk because of those fucking holes.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, so I'm just gonna have to keep a fucking plate on it.
Well, this is what I gotta do. I gotta let it cycle through.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna go down for a bit, and then on my way back, that's when I'll do it. So I gotta let it cycle through. So
I'm just gonna grab a drink real quick.
All right.
And just follow you, man.
Let's do it. Reaction is holy shit. Now it's not like you're getting like a tune from E85 or anything like that, but E85 is a lot harder to come by for a lot of people depending on where you're located. With Boostane, I mean, they can ship that just about anywhere. So do I recommend it? Yes. I don't know why you wouldn't. It's more power. And it's better than straight like 93 pump. So we're going to go back down here further down and flip back on the way and try it again. I like it. So flip back around on our way back. So more initial thoughts. Thing pulls hard. It's smooth all the way through the power band. Doesn't seem to lag or hiccup on anything. And that was a policeman. So, yeah, it doesn't have any lag. It doesn't have any. It just continues to pull all the way through. That's what I like about it. So. Drive the car that often, so I mean, I don't see, unless, you know, I run out, then I switch it over or go on like a road trip, which I'm taking this across state here next month, so obviously for situations like that, you know, not, but no, I like it. I just haven't had the chance. I've had it for a few days. It came in the day after the dyno last week. I just haven't had the chance to take the car out and throw it in there and see what it was like. So, initial reaction, thumbs up, I like it. So, but anyway, that was mainly what this video was designed for, is just to give my thoughts and opinion on it. If anyone, you know, was thinking about it and if they weren't sure if it was worth it and, didn't have access to, you know, other situations like E85 or stuff like that. Yeah, if you're able to, if you could swing it, it's definitely worth it, in my opinion. So, yeah. All right, guys. So that's going to do it for today. Kind of just wanted to make a quick video. Just like I said, just to see how everything felt before I took the car back to the dyno, because I wasn't happy with the 614. So, and then we threw in, obviously, the additive. So, hope this helped anybody out that was either on the fence with it or was just curious about it and wanted to know if it was worth it or not. So, yeah, just kind of a quick little informative video of it and my first initial impressions and just getting a idea on it before I took the car back, just to see my own personal, between the pump 93 and the Boostane. So anyway, dyno's coming up in a couple days, so I will see you guys in the next video, and, hope for good things. You guys have a good one, and I'll see you in the next video.